Hello, and welcome to episode 5 of Dank Dungeons. I'm Dan, the Dank Master, and you can watch this show on NCTV or on YouTube. We also have a Facebook and a Twitter, and we'd appreciate it if you checked it out. On our last episode, the group went into an underwater ruin. I'm trying to remember now. Went into an underwater ruin, almost got killed by a prehistoric fish. One of them got killed by a prehistoric fish, but Death let him come back. But that probably won't last very long now, will it? They found the second of the three medallions that they are currently seeking, and they approached the goblin stronghold after everyone was made invisible by Bettania, the mage's ritual spell. How are you all doing? Did I forget anything important from last time?
Nah, we still got a enchanted goat. We still
is
got
the goat
that.
Enchanted,
I don't think the goat's enchanted.
I'm trying to kill me.
I think it's just old.
It's just really old.
I think we're going to find out.
Who's really in charge here? Besides the goat.
You didn't roll to discern realities yet.
I'm sorry.
Did we also, were we actually ever actually made invisible?
We were made invisible. Right now we're invisible. They can't see us on the cameras.
Everybody's invisible right now.
Except for Dan.
Are we all invisible?
Yeah. We are so invisible.
Everybody's invisible. And you are infiltrating a goblin laboratory facility of some sort.
Technocracy of Zork.
From the Technocracy of Zork.
Woo!
Some of the soldiers of which you have encountered already earlier in your adventure.
If that's what you want to call it.
If you want to call it an encounter.
Also, I just want to make a note.
A murder and.
I want to make a note that when you said prehistoric fish, all I could hear was Prius. Toric fish? So when you said that we were by a prehistoric fish, I just kept hearing Prius.
It was old, like at grape fuel economy.
Oh no, it's got really good gas mileage. All right. The fuel economy is too good.
Let's get this show on the road.
Yeah.
Stop it.
Like so a Prius.
You are in the volcanic region of the valley. The large metal facility looms in front of you as you approach. All of you are visible. You see numerous groups of goblins walking around with their goofy metal armor and their energy sticks. Kind of just statements. Talking about nothing in particular with one another, like what they had for lunch, what they're going to have for lunch, how tired they are, how much they wish they had better health benefits, if they heard about that one dude who got burned alive. Last week's episode of Game of Thrones. You know, whether Walking Dead's still good or not. the typical thing. Yeah. There are a couple of larger goblins who are wearing less armor, but are really burly and kind of crazy looking. Like, all of them are cross-eyed, and you don't like the look of that.
Hello.
You don't think you want to mess with those
guys. I definitely don't like those guys.
When someone's cross-eyed all the time,
I kind of want to mess with those
guys. It's kind of freaks you out.
Just stop.
Even if it's a goblin.
Conceal, don't feel, Davis.
So yes, there is a large metal door. It appears to be like a sliding metal hatch of some kind on the front of the building. Next to it is a glass panel embedded into the wall. What do you do? None of them can see you, so as long as you guys don't do anything that would make a ton of noise, you can kind of just walk around.
Yeah, I'm gonna walk around.
Let's wait till somebody opens it and then sneak
just
in.
Just hang out.
Yeah, because I have a feeling
just hang
it's
out.
Some sort of like.
But it's a door.
Hand.
But do you have a feeling about that?
How much does
Todd know about the high tech wonders?
Yeah, what do I have? Maybe I should.
Of the technocracy of Zork.
Are there?
Maybe you should spout some lore.
Let's try that. Are any of the goblins smoking?
One of them is smoking what appears to be an e-cigarette.
An e-cigarette,
or is it a lightning stick?
Yeah, it's a smoking tube.
It's like a smaller version of their sword.
Yeah.
Oh boy.
We'll just call it an e-cigarette, though.
They're way beyond regular cigarettes.
They're way beyond regular cigarettes.
Yeah. They're too high-tech for that. Don't you know those things give you lung cancer?
Would you like
among other health problems?
Spout it.
Would you like me to spout some more? Yeah.
Spout some lore about
some
the dangers of cigarettes.
That's an intelligence thing, right?
Yes.
Fantastic.
Ooh.
4.
Got a 4?
Not so fantastic.
Well, mark experience.
Great.
You don't know what any of this is. You barely even remember where you are.
You guys ever heard of a panel on a wall next to the door?
Oh my god. Todd.
I think if we go around this corner, we'll be right where we're trying to get to. It's a dead end.
Oh boy. I'll try to spout some lore.
Okay.
Because I'm not
Are you going to try and spout some lore?
Dingus.
I'm going to try and steal that e-cigarette.
I'm just kidding. I'm
I mean, you can try.
See.
That's a 7, right?
That's a 7.
Word.
A 7?
Yeah.
Okay. On a 7-9...
I'm going to spout lore, too.
I will tell you something interesting.
Oh, tell me something interesting.
The glass panel appears to have numbers on it.
Okay.
Ooh.
I'm going now.
Like an elephant.
This is intelligence. I got
That's
an 11.
Far better.
Oh,
an 11.
Yeah.
Wow.
Dang, Dula.
I'll tell you something interesting and useful.
This is enough of that.
This subject.
Great.
So this is not something where it looks like, you know, like a. I'm gonna go outside of the game world a little bit because mm-hmm. you guys know how like. Hand scanners work. Mm-hmm. Doesn't appear to be something like that. It appears to be a keypad of some kind, mm-hmm. which you'll need a code. So,
I'm gonna just watch.
Perhaps you should find the code.
Yeah, I'm gonna just watch.
Just gonna watch and see if one of them opens it.
One of them opens it, and then I'll just be like, yo, that's a code right there.
yeah, just stand right next to it.
A single goblin.
That's a code.
You guys kind of
right
just stand
there.
Around, like loitering by the door,
loitering by the door,
invisible for a few minutes. Mm.
Stoop kids.
Stoop kids afraid to leave his stoop. And
Stoop kids just trying to find the key code. That's all he's trying to do.
Leave him alone.
And one of the goblins, after a few moments, approaches the keypad. And starts. Boop. 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 Darn it!
Oh no.
Boop. 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 Another goblin approaches him. Do you need help? Yeah, I can't remember the code. Boop.
How long does this go on for?
How long do you want it to go on for?
As long as it needs to be funny.
55 minutes?
55 We're probably minutes. Played out on that. So you stand around for like, you know, 10 minutes or so. They're not having much luck.
Oh boy.
It's just the two of them trying to figure it out. You see a third one walking over. Anyone want to intervene? Anyone want to do anything?
No, nope, just keep
You're just
watching.
Just gonna wait.
Somebody's gotta figure
this.
It out eventually.
Hours pass.
Okay. No.
11 goblins stand around the keypad.
I don't even know how to get in.
Finally, the door opens from the inside.
Rush in. We gotta rush
in. Yeah,
we gotta rush in.
Yup.
Gotta
rush in. All the other goblins are like, "Did we get it? I guess."
So we get in.
You get in.
Right.
You rush in before all the other goblins.
The goat and the wolf are with us, right?
Yeah. They're great. Invisible, too.
Great.
All the goblins come in as well and line up in front of a door to the left. There's a door to the left and a door to the right.
Mm.
The door to the right has a bunch of weird warnings on it in some kind of weird techno language that none of you understand.
Mm-hmm.
The door on the left has a little symbol that looks like it's like a bunch of goblins lined up, and all the goblins are lining up in front of it.
Let's go through the one with warnings.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sounds safe.
Sounds cool.
You are unsure how to open it.
Spout more?
I guess.
There are some potted plants in this room as well, which really add a nice bit of greenery to the otherwise metallic
good.
Decor.
So let's check out the door, I guess, with a bunch of goblins that are lined up.
Yeah, right. But they're all lined up, right? So we gotta wait.
Well, I mean,
gotta wait in line.
Steam shoots out from the edges of the door, like, and the hatch slowly opens, and all the goblins walk in and start taking off their clothes.
Mm.
I'm gonna sneak in.
You're just gonna walk in with them?
I'm gonna walk in with them.
Are you
them.
Gonna take off your clothes?
No, why would you do that?
I'm invisible. I mean, maybe. When
well,
Rome.
Don't plant seeds here. Don't.
Are you gonna take off your clothes? Is anybody else going in?
No.
You're
gonna take your wolf with you?
Yeah, come what's this?
Bettania.
Is it a small room?
Oh,
it's
no.
It's a small room.
Bettania.
It's not like tiny. It's roomy enough for like.
Well,
the
this is our shot. We don't know how these doors open. We may as well take advantage of the open one.
Yeah.
Then we go in and it's like.
What about you, Bettania?
Oh, I really don't want to see some.
You and the goat are the X Factor right now.
I don't want to see some goblin ding dongs.
You have to look at them.
I don't like
You would have
that.
To deliberately look down.
Yeah, they're tiny.
Like, way down.
You'd have to, like,
because they're so small.
There's so many goblins, though.
You'd have to, like, get
what
on the ground.
What if one just, like,
Can we see
out?
Each other?
What no, if one of them's, like, really big?
Yeah, like a well-endowed goblin.
Doesn't and make, you just, like, can't
doesn't
avoid
make it
looking.
Any better.
Like, I mean...
just can't look away.
Like, you can't avoid looking at
you're
it.
Like, oh,
I can't
my.
Unsee that.
It's like hitting people as he walks by. Like, all knocking right, them out of the way. Yeah, too
far. All right. Let's, okay, we're going in. Are you coming?
Some of the goblins sit on a bench that's on the side of the wall. Like,
nope.
Others are just kind of standing around.
I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
Can we see each other?
No.
Great.
Ooh.
So we don't even know if
you don't
we're
even
all
know if
together.
I'm going with you.
You've all just kind of done the same thing.
So we're all like whispering to each other.
I mean, you could. They probably wouldn't notice.
We
I'm
holding hands. We can all
this.
Hold
yeah,
hands.
Yeah, me and Todd are holding hands.
And me and my wolf have a bond. So
I know you sense like each other.
It's like you're always holding hands.
Aww. Like you're always holding
something.
Holding mine hands.
All right.
Your wolf says, I feel sort of uncomfortable about this plan. But he walks in, you know, he takes off his pants.
Well, I forgot to mention he wears pants.
Oh, he's right. Wearing pants
what?
The whole time.
Yeah, wolf's yeah. Wearing pants.
Twist
the whole
ending.
Whoa. All
right.
Who's really in charge here?
So
well, the wolf
in.
Wears the pants. So.
Suddenly, as soon as you guys enter, and Batanga's like, mm-mm.
Mm-mm.
You and the goat are standing outside.
Awesome.
The door closes behind
you.
And you hear as it seals.
You're the spell person.
Green lights come out of the walls.
Yeah.
And
you're fine. Blow,
blow, blow, and scan everything in the room.
Oh, no.
And suddenly, an alarm goes up.
Oh, no! You guys went in the wrong room!
And then you hear over the loudspeaker, a loudspeaker system comes on, and you hear...
What does that mean?
And then all the goblins start sort of just looking at each other. And then the other door opens, and all the goblins walk out and put their clothes back on.
Wait.
And the alarm stops.
That's good.
I guess we'll go with them.
You're going to go with them?
I mean, we're going to stay in this room.
Yeah, I'm going to go too.
You find yourselves in a...
I'm going to take my bow out too.
A very shiny... hallway, like entry hall kind of thing. There's some cushioned chairs around. There's more potted plants. There's a vending machine in the corner. Mm. It's like lit with like fluorescent lights, so everyone looks kind of pasty. There's a poster on the wall of like a green cat hanging onto a clothesline that says "Hang in there, baby" at the bottom. Like, looks like, you know, there's a water cooler. It's pretty good.
Oh boy.
The goblins
the
start
way.
Like milling about. A lot of them start heading to the left. There's a door straight ahead, but there's also a hallway to the left and a hallway to the right.
Are there signs? Any sort of signs that?
There's signs in goblin techno language. Bettania, what would you like to do?
I would like.
You're not sure
to...
what happened. You heard an alarm and.
Well, that was scary, guys. Let's check out this door, all of us together. Assuming that you guys didn't go in that stupid door.
We did.
I guess I would like to try to discern realities and all see right. if there's any clues of how to open this other door.
Sure.
Cool. I did not do a great job. I got a 4+. What's the modifier on that?
Intelligence, I believe.
That's a 5.
A 5, okay. Mark experience.
Yeah.
That's not good enough.
Woohoo!
The goat looks at you, goes,
mm-hmm.
and walks over to the...
Can I see the goat?
No.
We're all invisible.
I mean, you hear him bleat, though.
Oh.
And you hear
hooves on the ground. Like,
bad awesome. Sneaking.
And then you hear a boom, and you see the door... that they didn't go through, the other one, mm-hmm. with all the, like, warnings on it.
Yeah.
You see it kind of shake a little bit. And
I mean,
what was that?
That's the one I want to go in. I know.
You want to walk over?
I do want to.
The goat's over there.
I do want to walk over and examine that door.
Who could it be at this hour?
Shut up, goat.
Here. Beep.
Boop. Is the goat trying to get in the door?
Dang it!
No, it's
from, this is the, from the other side. Yeah.
Oh god!
Oh god!
The door flies up.
Yes!
This is a smarter goblin. This is a smart goblin.
Nobody's here.
I'm rushing in. I'm rushing
in. He's gonna plow past him.
Yup. Plowing in.
Roll me a strength roll. A push past this little goblin. It's not gonna be hard to beat him.
6, 7. That's 6. Y plus one.
Nope, I'm wrong.
I'm really weak, bro.
I know,
it's a 6.
It's a 6.
All right.
I thought it was...
So, Mark experience.
Yes!
So
leveling up today.
You run into the goblin and kind of tumble over him.
Woohoo!
And flip over into the room, and you find yourself in what looks like a control room of some kind.
Excellent.
There's little windows that are looking down into the room next to it, mm-hmm. which is the room that they all went into, which is now empty, you see.
Okay.
There is a door. If you keep going, there's another door that like leads out deeper into the compound, it looks like. But there is a keypad on that one as well. The goblin's like, oh, jeez, that's some strong wind indoors.
For a technocracy, they're pretty stupid.
He gets up and he starts beep-booping the keypad, trying to get the door to close, you're assuming.
Cool.
You hear as the goat walks up next to you.
Awesome. Go ahead.
What are you guys doing?
Let's go to the right.
Let's go to the right with you.
You're going to go to the right.
Let's go to the right.
Let's go to the right.
You go to the right. You go down a small hallway before reaching a door that appears to just have a handle on it.
Ooh.
I'm going to put my ear up to the door and see if I can hear anything on the other side.
You can hear some glass clinking and some mumbled voices.
Do they sound like goblin voices?
Yes, they do.
I'm going to knock on the door.
Oh, not a bad idea, actually. I'm going to back away from the door.
Knock and back away.
All right, you knock on
the door. Are you going to say knock, knock, knock when you knock, too?
In a goblin voice?
Knock, knock, knocking on goblin's door.
The door opens from the inside, yeah. And a goblin in a long white coat with big, huge lenses on his eyes says, is there anybody there?
I'm gonna like look into the room real quick, see what I can see in there.
It's full of like
I'm gonna walk down
beakers
the hall.
And glasses full of strangely colored liquids.
Ooh. I'm gonna walk down
and creatures that are being dissected. Like dinosaurs that have been cut open and pieces of them are like littering the room. It's like an experiment room.
It's like the lab in Jurassic Park.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
It's got kind of a vibe like that.
Ooh. I'm gonna walk down
cans of shaving cream everywhere.
Oh god.
I'm gonna walk down the hall and then knock again on the wall.
Oh, farther down the way.
Farther down ahead.
Hello! He walks out of the room. He walks right past you.
I'm going to walk into the room.
You're going to go into the
after
room?
After he walks out.
Okay.
Yeah. And then,
we're Scooby doing this thing.
I'm going to keep doing it as we go down the hall.
Why are you making such a noise?
Knock, knock, knock.
This is their scientist.
You're going to lead it back to the entry hall?
Yeah, lead it back to the entry hall, and then I'm going to knock.
Oh, God. Where are you knocking?
I'm going to keep knocking, all right?
Where are you knocking now?
Is there a door?
Another door?
There's a hallway to the left also, and there's another door.
Right in front?
It was like straight ahead from where you came in.
I'm going to go up to that. I'm going to knock on it.
Oh, my God.
He walks over to that door. That door also opens. There's another goblin on the other side, and they bump into each other. And the one that just opened the door says, what do you want? What do you want? You knocked. No, I didn't.
What's going on in that room?
What's going on in that room?
Are you
going
to go in?
Well, I'm going to peek in, but I'm not going to actually stay. I got to get back to my buddy.
Okay.
But you don't know where I am.
There are large glass tubes stretching from floor to ceiling.
Okay.
And inside of them are horrifically mutated reptilian creatures.
Great.
Suspended in a yellowish liquid.
Ooh. Is there another door in this room?
Not that you can see glancing through quickly.
Okay.
There's too many big tubes full of...
No, not in this room. I mean, the room I was just in.
No.
The room where I knocked on.
Just a hallway to the left.
Just a hallway to the left?
Yeah. You are in this experiment room. There are two other goblins in here who are just kind of doing their work. One of them's cutting apart a like small armored creature of some kind.
Are there any living creatures in here? Are they all dead?
No, they're not. They're all dead. And another one is just kind of pouring liquid back and forth between two glasses, going, oh, jeez. Oh, man.
Is there anything that seems important? Like anything that I'm looking for? Maybe certain realities or something?
It's mostly just scientific equipment.
All right, I'm going to leave.
Nothing particularly interesting. There is a door to the left that exits out of this room, though.
I don't want to get too far. I'm going to go out.
Go try and...
Yeah, when I leave... Well, he's just, like, down the hallways away, right?
Oh, no, he went all the way back in the entry hall.
Well, I'm going to try and find that other goblin.
Okay.
So that's what I'm looking for.
So you're in this command room.
Because, I mean, I was there for the knocking
with
down the hallway.
What would you like to do?
I guess I would like to discern realities and see what happens in here.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah, go for it.
K. can't cast any spells because we're invisible. That's a 10, 11.
11?
Yeah.
Okay, so what kind of realities would you like to discern?
Oh my gosh.
These three questions.
What has just happened here?
It appears as though a bunch of goblins were allowed through a checkpoint of sort.
Cool, Dan.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I don't know. This action is weird because it doesn't really give you much to go off of.
No.
Without it just being your character suddenly realizes everything about the known universe.
Just poof.
Yeah.
Who is the true god?
It's like metagaming the ability.
Yeah, kind of.
Here's the thing you have no business knowing as your character. You have two more questions, though.
I do, and they don't have to be questions from that list, right?
No.
They can be any
Whatever
questions.
You want. Those are just examples.
Well, it's really up to you to decide if you want to answer.
Actually, yeah.
Who's really in charge here, besides the goat?
Besides the goat.
It's always the goat. You know, it's always the goat.
It's hard to say besides the goat.
Has the medallion been through here?
That's not a fair question at all.
It's not, but I rolled an 11.
Yeah. You know what? Yes. Because I'm tired of talking around these stupid questions.
Awesome.
So from now on, if you guys do discern realities and ask me a question, I'm just going to tell
I'm just
you.
Just going to answer honestly.
Excellent.
Because I'm awesome. Sick of it. Okay. I'm so sick of it.
Does the other person in this room, the goblin, know how I can get to it?
Yes.
Excellent. Okay.
I'm so yawny today.
You are. You're
Me
so
too.
Sleepy there. You
I had feel a, like I'm yawny every
it's
time.
A sleepy day.
You had a long work day.
I did.
My name is Lance.
Okay. I can't cast any other spells, otherwise you guys will all turn uninvisible.
Nice. Yeah, that would be terrific.
That would be
just
amazing.
Make everybody visible. So what are your other options here?
I'm just knocking down the hall, suddenly visible.
Then suddenly you're visible, and the goblins are like, whoa, that's a huge lizard.
Better cut it up.
Man, it would be too meta for me to just knock on the other door. So I guess I'm going to spy on this goblin that's here.
You're going to spy on him?
I'm going to spy.
You're just going to sit with him for a while?
I'm just going to sit with him for a minute.
Okay.
Me and the goat chill for
he
a second.
He eventually gets the door closed, and he goes back and sits in his chair in front of like the command console.
Just going to look over
so
his shoulder.
Drinking his drink. Mm-hmm. He's got a little glass of water.
Interesting.
Not really doing anything else, just twiddling his thumbs. Seems like he has a boring job.
I was going to say, it seems like a crap runner. Life.
Tip the water.
Oh,
make his life worse.
It's not a bad idea.
It's not the worst idea. Maybe he'll need to go into the other side
or
of
maybe
the door
it,
to clean himself
or,
up.
Or maybe it is the worst idea.
You know what? I'm going to tip that water over right onto his lap.
Onto his lap?
Onto his crotch, so not right on, here.
So not onto the console.
So it looks like he's peed himself. And he's going to have to mess. He's going to have to clean that up.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez.
I knew it was coming.
Oh.
It looks like I peed myself.
It does.
You have to make a roll to stop from laughing.
He takes off his pants.
And his jacket.
No!
And just throws him in the corner.
This is what I tried to avoid.
And then he sits down in the chair.
With no pants on.
With no pants on.
Okay, maybe his job doesn't seem so bad.
Oh, man.
Oh, it's getting chilly.
Oh, geez.
I bet
he hits
it is.
A button on the console and a little heat vent opens under the chair and starts blowing hot air up.
Right into his...
Oh, no.
Right into his business there.
Oh, no.
God. Business. Goblin genitals. Man.
Can we cut there and come back to
us? Yeah, that's fine.
The thrilling adventures of Bettania and the goblin.
It's not thrilling for me. It's not.
It's thrilling for the goblin.
Oh, wow.
So I'm trying to find this guy.
You're trying to find that guy. You see two goblins standing in front of a door, standing on either side of a door, talking about who opened the door and who wants what and whether one of them wanted something or not. And you're assuming the Dula Wula Fula has gone.
Well, I remember a whole place. Knocking thing.
Yeah, you heard the knocking as he was going down the hall. So
I'm going to keep knocking, and I'm going down the left corridor this time.
Okay, I'm going to
follow the knocks.
Okay, yeah, I'm going to...
What do the goblins do?
I'm going to follow. I'm going to go up to where...
More knocking down the hallway.
What is happening?
What is this? Is this some kind of new drill? What's going on? Right. It's going towards the cafeteria.
Oh, so we know.
So they all, a couple of them are already just walking down this hallway.
Okay.
And you arrive shortly in a cafeteria. There's a bunch of tables. There's a big ugly goblin behind a counter, just kind of shoveling like nondescript food, like some kind of paste onto plates.
Yeah.
The goblins are taking, they're sitting down and they're eating their goo.
Okay.
Having a great time.
Are there any doors?
Yeah, there's a door on the right.
I'm gonna knock on it.
No answer.
No answer.
Ooh. No answer.
No answer.
It's got a handle.
I'll try and open it.
It opens. There's a small hallway and another door.
I'm knocking that door.
No answer.
I'll open it.
I'm following it.
You're following him at this point? Okay, you catch up.
Yeah.
You open it?
Yeah.
You are in the room full of the experimental tanks full of...
I guess I'll look around in
dinosaurs of various types.
This is the same room?
Yes. Seems to be like a central chamber.
That was the first one? Or no, that was the second room, right?
Yeah, this is the other one he glanced into after leading the goblin.
Okay, I'm going to be like, hey, let's go back to that first room. There was another door in there.
I'm going to be like, who goes there?
You know who
is this demon? Who wants to? I'll burn you alive.
Just relax.
So wait, where are you? I'll burn you.
Not going to say anything at that point. At that point.
Whatever.
Yeah. I'm going to go. There's nobody in this room, right?
No.
Because they left.
Not that you can see.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to knock on the door.
That's my thing.
Which door are you knocking on?
The one
he already
to leave this room. Oh. Not the one back into the cafeteria area. Because this is the room, the second room we went into where he knocked on the door and they answered, right?
Knocking was OP.
No.
Oh.
I'm confused.
So you've been to three rooms. Okay. There's the entry hall. To the left is the little cafeteria, which you went through. To the right is the science room you found.
Yep.
And then straight ahead.
That room, right?
You are in that room, but you entered from the left side.
So I'm knocking on the door going back into the hallway.
Can I try spouting low in this room?
Wait. You mean the one that goes back into the entryway?
Yes.
That door's open. There's two goblins standing in front of it.
Oh, really?
Who opened it.
Oh, I thought they went to the cafeteria because he was knocking down the way.
No, those two stayed there.
They stayed?
There was a bunch of other goblins.
Then I'm not doing that. Okay.
That's why I was confused. Okay.
Can I try and spout lore in the room?
Yeah, totally.
So I'll do that. Okay, got to roll. What am I rolling for? What's the modifier?
Intelligence.
Intelligence. Just dropping stuff?
Yeah, I'm just getting rid of it.
I got a 11.
All the creatures in the tanks appear to be alive. They're hooked up to various wires and tubes.
Mm-hmm. So they're all alive?
But they look pretty janky,
they seem
right?
Like they're alive. They're all messed up. They're all like mutated and freaky.
I'm going to go to the tank that's closest to the goblins.
Nope. Okay.
That are at the door talking about who opens what.
And then he's going to open it. I'm okay. Yep. That's where invisible.
I know what's going to happen right now.
The creature inside shifts a little bit, but nothing else happens.
The goblins don't care that the.
They're discussing who opened the door.
Are they arguing who opened? They're like,
getting pretty heated.
I just want to. I guess I just want to look around the room then. Are there any other exits?
Yeah. There's another exit to, like, to the north.
Want to check out the north?
Because you have...
So there's three exits to this room?
Four.
Oh, my goodness.
So I want to check out what's
seems up, to though. Be a central chamber.
Let's
it's
check
like the
that
biggest
out.
Room, too.
I'll knock on that door.
Okay. We'll get back to that. Bettania, what are you doing back in the control room?
So this is a chamber that has windows out to a bunch of different rooms.
It has windows out just to that first, that one room.
to the steam shower.
The steam shower.
Because of my... lady-like sensibilities. And then there's another door.
Yes.
I'm going to go up to the other door, and I am going to... It's a keypad?
It looks like it, yeah.
I'm going to press some random numbers.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's see what happens.
Yeah! Let's do that.
You press three buttons in sequence. Mm-hmm. Nothing happens. Do you just keep pressing buttons?
Yep.
Who's pressing all those buttons?
I don't know. Who is doing that?
The pantsless goblin gets up from his chair and waddles over to you.
Mm-hmm.
He bumps into you.
Why does he do that?
Because he's trying to walk over to the keypad and you're standing in front of it. Oh my god! What's this? He reaches his hands out.
No, he does not.
He's touching your leg.
No, he doesn't.
What do you do?
I do one of those moves like a baseball player does when the ball is coming right at their pelvis and they go like, woo! Do one of those.
Do you do it towards him or away from him?
Away from him so that like the legs are like away and so like he's just touching nothing.
He's just touching nothing?
Yeah.
Oh my god, it moved!
Because he was already touching.
Yeah, because he was already touching me. I don't want him to touch me. Those are my legs. I did not give consent
you
for that.
You hear a loud bleat from the goat. And a clattering of hooves. And finally, he impacts the goblin with his horns.
Dang,
becoming visible.
Why did he?
And slamming the goblin against the door.
No, you can't attack anything, otherwise you become... No!
He bleats angrily at you.
I'm really mad at him, too. Tell him that.
You can tell him.
You can't tell him.
Oh,
that,
I
he
am
doesn't understand.
So mad at him right now. Are we all visible
the,
right now?
The goblin sure is knocked unconscious.
The spell participant
is... The goat is visible.
Okay.
The rest of you are not.
We are still invisible.
Yeah.
What
the only
dingus.
Time that we would all become visible is if she cast a spell, right?
He's getting impatient.
I'm going to ransack his pockets.
Oh.
Goblin pockets.
Did the
you
goblin...
walk over to where he left his pants.
You could have done that all along.
Dang it.
You find a small notebook.
What's in the notebook?
Inside of it is a bunch of key codes. Most of them are scratched out and replaced with other key codes.
Because they forgot them.
I'm going to try the ones that aren't scratched out.
Okay. None of them work.
I'm going to try some of the ones that are scratched out.
All right. You managed to make one out, punching it in, and the door finally opens.
Awesome.
It seems like he probably didn't mean to scratch it out, but he had already scratched it out, and he was writing in pen, so you know.
Oh, that's how you always make mistakes.
Except,
that's
you know, why you don't
it,
use
you
pen.
Didn't think of that.
He didn't think of that, no. He just knew that that one that was scratched out was actually not supposed
this
to be
right
scratched
one.
Out.
Yeah. So the door opens. The goat walks into the entry hall. No goblins pay him any mind.
Wait, we're back in the entry hall?
This is like the second
You haven't
entry
been
hall.
Here yet. This is you the one that
this
we
is
were
the one
in.
Oh,
right?
came into. It's getting very confused because you've all separated.
Yeah. Well, and now there's just a goat walking around.
There's also just a goat walking around. Two goblins are standing in a doorway in front of you arguing about who opened the door. Another goblin's asleep in a chair. Another goblin is asleep on the floor. And one goblin is just drinking a bottle of orange liquid. And he doesn't look like he's enjoying it.
Man.
He's like, oh, this is disgusting.
Yes. No.
Oh, man.
What would you like to do?
Cry is what
just
I would like
weep.
To do. Just right cry down uncontrollably. I would like to...
What would you guys like to do? Well, Bettania's
deciding go to the door.
Do.
The door we haven't got
yeah,
to.
Yeah, he okay. knocked on
the north.
You knocked,
knocked
there's
on
no
it.
Answer.
There's no answer?
No.
Is there a keypad or a handle?
There's a handle.
I open
yes.
You're in a hallway.
I'm in a hallway?
You're in a hallway.
We'll go to the other door at
You're
the end of the
hallway.
Hallway.
Well, you can go left or right.
Left.
You go left, there's another door with a handle.
Knock on it.
No answer.
I'm trying to distinguish. Man. I'm not trying... While this is happening, I'm kind of like, which way are you going? If there's like a split.
It's a room full of brooms.
A turnaround.
And other cleaning supplies.
A turnaround.
Okay. I think they call that a closet.
Yeah. Go the other way. And of
you
course,
the other way.
Bumping into Todd.
Bumping into Todd. You just like shoulder
and
check
be like, oh, nerd.
Yeah, it's probably pretty hard to not bump into each other.
Have you decided what you're doing?
I'm the only other.
Which room am I in? The entryway? The second entryway?
Yes.
So ahead of me is the room with all the tanks. To the right of me is the science lab. And to the left of me is the cafeteria?
Yes.
I go...
You got it figured out.
I go into the room with the tanks.
Yes.
I bust open the tanks.
Whoa.
With my staff.
You're just going to smash them open?
I'm just going to smash them open.
She's got to sneak past.
Make me an attack roll.
Bring it.
And yeah, make me a dexterity roll to sneak past those guys without them noticing you.
Dexterity roll, I did not do. That was a 4.
Okay. Mark experience.
Awesome. And
well,
what was the other one?
Strength. Or an attack with your staff. So strength, I think.
Oh, yeah, that's a 3. And that's
all right, Mark experience.
So you bump past these guys, and they're like,
"What?" Shove past the goblin.
Yep.
And they're like, "What's happening?
What the heck? Why'd you push me? I didn't push you. You pushed me." And then you run over to a tank and you just go, "Dum!" And then you make this super loud noise, but nothing else happens.
Not to be a jerk, but
yeah.
Goblins are too busy arguing with each other.
And you are visible now.
No! That was what I was trying to avoid.
Yeah. There's no goblins in this room that you can tell.
So you shut the other door. I shut the other door.
You shut it behind them?
I shut it behind me and...
Lock it.
I use my staff to bar it.
It's not that kind of handle.
Man!
It's like set into the door. So you have to kind of, it's got like, you can't really.
Oh, it's like a.
You need something bendy to wedge it.
I don't have anything.
Where are we now? We're just.
You're in the hallway.
Okay.
Going to the right.
Like right outside.
Door.
Right outside that room.
Right.
Yeah. A very important look. Oops, I bumped my mic.
Yeah.
A very important looking door.
I knock on it.
Good call.
Who is there?
Well, that doesn't sound good.
Okay, I'm gonna try in my best.
Oh no.
Like maybe you should.
I'll do it. I'm just gonna be like, oh, we're lost.
Indeed you are, for you have found my chambers, peon.
Yeah.
Leave immediately.
Oh. I'm hungry.
The cafeteria is down the hall to the left, and then halfway through the tank room to the right.
I'm hurt. My legs.
Take it up with medical.
I can't move.
I'm gonna be like,
man. I heard that the overseer is just like Uckley and doesn't like people to see his face. It's fine. I bet no one can convince us otherwise unless, like, we got to see his face.
It'd be funny if he was like,
I guess we'll
just. That's not a goblin.
I guess we're just gonna have to go because the overseer is too ugly to see us. I wish I could, but my legs.
Who's that well spoken fellow with you?
That's. Corn? I'm Corn.
His name's Corn. There are 15 goblins named Corn in this facility.
This one spelled with the backwards R. And a K.
Ah, yes. Corn. You did good on your duties yesterday. Come in, please. Share with me a cup of goblin juice. The door opens on its
goblin
own.
Goblin juice.
Inside is a lavishly appointed wood-paneled room.
Is there a person?
Oriental throw rug on the floor.
Woo!
A great leather chair sits before a mahogany desk. Mm. It spins about,
yes.
Gold filigree twinkling in the lights. And in it sits the most handsome goblin you've ever seen.
Oh, no.
Like square jaw.
Oh yeah, square jaw.
Perfect
with the
teeth.
Little. Like,
he just looks like a human, but he's, little,
yeah. He's just a green
human,
like human.
He's with a green old, James Dean
with a big old. What's that actor's name?
George
the guy
Clooney?
In Evil Dead.
Oh, Bruce Campbell.
Big old Bruce Campbell
oh,
chin.
Oh, beautiful.
Long
oh.
Fabio hair.
Oh. Wow.
Like tied back in a ponytail.
Wow.
He turns his chair around. And says, welcome. You're not Corn.
How can he even? He can't
see
so he can see us.
You're no one.
Be like, okay. I'm gonna be like,
we're still here. It's just,
what are you?
We got used as test subjects for the science department.
I see. I see.
Invisible.
That's how my legs broke.
He tripped. He didn't. He thought everything was invisible.
What are you doing?
And he just tripped over a table and he broke his leg.
Very well. Take a seat. Allow me to pour you a tall glass of this goblin juice. He reaches over and grabs several like nice wine glasses.
I'm gonna spout lore and see if goblin juice is actually a thing that
starts
I know
pouring
about.
Pouring a brown liquid,
is that
a muddy
okay?
brown liquid
oh,
into
God.
The. Yeah.
I'm gonna try and figure that out.
Bettania, what's the score?
I got 12.
Ooh.
As far as you know, goblin juice doesn't exist.
Okay, good.
This is something he made up.
Okay, I'm not interested in goblin juice then. But I don't have to drink it.
You
I'm invisible.
This adventure sounds very sexy. I'm very jealous. So I've just closed the door behind the two arguing goblins. I'm visible.
Yes.
There's a door in three directions, I'm assuming,
yes.
in this chamber.
Straight ahead, left and right.
I will go to the one to my right.
Okay. You open it. Mm-hmm. You are in a laboratory of some sort, mm-hmm. full of dissected creatures and strange liquids.
Are there goblins in there?
There are two.
I go,
one of them is pouring liquid back and forth between two bottles, and he seems very worried about it, and the other is staring at him.
Ooh. I run over, yell, "So sorry," break the beaker on the floor. Just one of them.
Why do you even yell "so sorry"?
Because I feel so bad about it.
For comedic effect.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
You slap it to the ground.
It looks like a thing that will be helpful to me.
They're just going to think that you're like handicapped.
The bottle hits.
That's helpful. Yeah.
The glass bottle hits the ground.
Yep.
Breaks open.
Explosion.
It says, "Ted's urine sample."
Damn it.
Now we'll never know if he has hepatitis.
Because that's how you find out.
Damn.
Exactly.
Yeah. She's not invisible
it's
anymore.
It's okay. But I'll go get another one. The goblin who was watching leaves the room.
They don't even care that...
Cool, bye, guys. Back to the middle chamber.
Oh, hello.
Bye. Hello, goodbye. Whoops.
Do you close the door behind you?
Absolutely, I
Thank
do.
Thank you.
I take the next door, which is the one that was straight ahead of me.
Yes. You're in a hallway. To the right is an open chamber that looks very, very decorative and fancy. You hear a deep come from the room.
What else is there? What else is there?
There's a broom closet to your left.
What else is there?
Nothing.
Hide in the broom closet.
Oh.
Okay.
So Scooby-Doo.
So you two... This handsome goblin hands you, I mean, he holds out two glasses of goblin juice.
Uh-huh. I'm gonna be like, them? I've never heard of goblin juice.
It is something of my own invention.
Oh, what is
a
it?
A drink that will soon take Zork by storm.
What is it?
It's a secret.
Oh, no.
I don't drink secret stuff.
It's made
stuff.
With fruits
I have
of
a lot
this
of
valley.
I have a lot of allergies.
The last time we drank secret stuff, we turned invisible and he broke his leg, so...
Nonsense.
I feel like...
I insist.
Oh, boy.
I'm going to take the cup and I'm going to drop it and be like, whoops!
My
broken legs
I'm
couldn't
take
hold
it. I'm
going to
take
cups.
A cup and I'm just going to pour it down my pants.
And then go,
yum, yum, yum.
It's like a goblin's drinking it.
It tastes delicious.
You slap the glass to the ground.
No, I take it and then I drop it.
Or you yeah, okay, yeah, you drop, it. Excuse me, I misspoke. The glass hits the ground after you drop it, shatters.
Oh, no.
And the liquid begins to burn through the floor as a powerful acid takes hold. Meanwhile,
I'm gonna be like, "That's weird."
Fula pours the liquid down his trousers.
Nope.
And screams bloody murder as his entire lower body is melted away.
No,
you are dead.
Great.
There's nothing we can do to get around that.
Okay.
Your character was already supposed to die at some point, and you just, like, asked for it.
Alrighty. Okay.
I don't know how we're going to proceed from here.
You think everyone who drinks a strange liquid is asking for it?
Can we just...
They were handed a strange liquid by a goblin who's clearly more intelligent than the other goblins here.
Oh, no.
Well,
a liquid that with a 12 he'd never heard of.
Oh, man.
What are you doing, man? What's wrong with you?
You can't talk to him. He's dead.
Todd, you saw his whole lower body melt.
I didn't see anything.
He's invisible.
I mean,
unless dying
make
brings
him
you
invisible again?
I think so.
I'm going to say it does. Yeah.
That feels fair.
Aha! A lizard in our midst. Tell me, other lizard. Are your legs still broken, or wish you to run away?
Like, I think I'm supposed to kill you now.
Indeed, have at you. He draws a laser sword.
Okay, oh. I'm gonna run to the corner of the room, kind of quietly, just like.
Okay.
And then just sit there with my arrow knocked.
He's standing there like this.
Okay.
With his arm behind his back and his sword up.
I'm going to try and, like, sneak around.
You, from inside the closet, hear Dula Wula Fula scream.
Oh, boy.
And then a thud as something hits the ground. And then some yelling, muffled yelling of speech.
Oh, boy.
What would you like to do?
I examine the broom closet.
It's full of cleaning supplies.
Any sort of bleaches?
Yes.
Ooh, interesting.
Seems to be some bad-smelling chemicals in here.
I'm going to see if any of my books are chemistry books.
One can certainly be if you want it to be.
One of them's a chemistry book. I'm going to make a bomb.
Okay. Dula Wula Fula, would you like to take control of the goat?
Ooh.
I guess.
At least I don't know. For now. Has to give you something to do.
Sure.
Okay. You're the goat now.
Yeah, where am I?
Wow. You are with Bettania in the broom closet.
I wish I were dead. God!
Get to be the goat.
Mm-hmm. That's amazing.
So I will, I still gotta voice the goat and everything, but you can decide the goat's path of action.
Okay.
As long as it's like...
Can I also say what the goat says?
I mean, you can have some... You can have some control over it. Sure, yeah. We'll do it by committee.
Yeah, okay. We'll do it by committee. Yeah.
All right. We'll goat votes.
Goat seems like goat he's votes. Pretty... Goat seems like he's a pretty impatient guy.
Yeah, I mean, he wants these medallions found.
So, Goat's just gonna break open the door.
Damn it, Goat!
Okay, you're gonna try and bonk the door open?
Just bonk the door open. Okay.
While you're doing that, did you roll to figure out something you can do with these chemicals?
No. I rolled an 8, plus I'm guessing intelligence is a 9.
Yes, plus one more for using your books.
That's a 10.
A 10? Mm. All right, what are you trying to figure out how to do here? I'm
trying to figure out how to make a very distracting and awesome killer bomb.
Do you want it to be a distracting bomb or a killer bomb?
Yeah, there's gotta be. There's a difference.
I'm gonna guess it's gonna be a distracting bomb.
You want to just go to killing?
My alignment is good.
I suppose
that's
true. I'm
not gonna go straight to killing.
I kind of feel bad for that smart goblin. He's got to work with all these idiots all the time.
Mm-hmm. I mean, somebody's gotta be the brains behind every operation.
Aha, a lizard.
Just as I suspected.
Obviously it was a lizard. How about
I could
you,
tell by that
other lizard?
That's the best part. Yeah.
That awful goblin impression.
that was clearly a lizard. How was my goblin impression?
It was much better.
Great.
The broken legs was believable.
I think he ruined it for me. It might have been good if it was just me.
Turn the party against each other.
Oh, God.
Well, he's dead.
Figure out how to make some sort of chemical bomb.
Ooh.
It might be deadly. In fact, there's no way I can really think of that it wouldn't be deadly, given the things you're probably making it with.
Fair enough.
But you think it's
you mix a bunch of stuff in a bucket, and then put a lid on it, and then the bucket starts kind of shaking.
Yup.
It's very volatile.
Yup.
What are you going to do now?
I carry it into
the goat has burst the door open.
I run to that central chamber. I set it there. I run back. I hide in the broom closet.
The central chamber?
Yep.
Oh, my God.
We're going for ultimate chaos here.
Dear sweet lord.
Here we go.
You run back to the broom closet?
Yeah, to take cover. Duck and cover.
A deafening explosion rattles through the facility.
Okay.
Which you hear.
Perfect, perfect.
From that room.
All right, how does the goblin react?
What was that?
That's when I let go of my arrow.
Oh, roll your attack.
And I do a called shot on him.
So you're visible now.
How does that work now?
Okay, it says a defenseless or surprised enemy at range.
There you go. All
right.
You're visible now.
And I'm going for...
So you're rolling for a volley.
I'm going for his... his arms.
Is EP attacking as well?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm going for his arms.
Okay.
So as a... okay, so I have to get a 10 plus to do damage.
Yes.
7 to 9, he drops anything he's holding.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, Lord, please hit.
Come on, you got this. No.
8.
Ooh. 8?
8.
He drops his energy sword. Yes. You just don't deal any damage.
Great.
Cool. My blade! Oh! he's like, I must find out what happened! Goat's turn. Yeah. You're down the hallway.
Yeah.
You're just kind of like, oh.
Does he come out of the hall?
Is there even still a door to that closet anymore, or did he break it?
You like bonked it open, okay. But it can still close.
Is the handsome goblin running out?
Yes.
I'm just gonna run straight into his.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna try and knock him over.
I'm just gonna run straight.
His
what
testicles.
Is this goat doing here? My goodness.
So roll to attack.
Oh my god.
Give yourself a +2, because this goat has 6 stats.
Wow. Man.
You get kicked in your goat head.
More experience?
Sure.
The goat level's up.
If you want to.
Oh, man.
Sure. Mark it. Write it down.
Okay.
So he kind of trips over you, but you don't really manage to stop him. Are you, like, looking out the door at all now that this chaos is ensuing? You hear, what is this goat doing here?
Nope, I am with... I'm in the closet.
Oh, I'm visible now.
The rooms. You are visible
okay,
now.
Great.
You are visible.
Everyone's visible.
Then I
now.
Would just say it's your turn again. If nobody else is doing it.
Well, I'm going to, like, shoot another arrow at him.
Fire at him? Yeah, from back?
Yeah, a regular. Oh, actually. I could. I'll do his legs this time. He's hobbled and slow moving if I hit him. All right?
Okay.
Here we go.
Sounds good.
7.
7?
Yeah.
He's hobbled.
All right,
and
cool.
Slow moving.
Cool.
He keeps dragging himself towards that room. I must see if my great experiment has survived. He's now kind of like pulling himself along. Like, oh!
I'm going to get out and be like, goat! Good to see you.
It is good to see you as well.
What happened to
the... Yeah, you can do it now.
What happened to the evil lizard?
Oh. He's gone. Actually, I'm going to turn and kind of like point at the mess on the floor.
That is good.
Great.
Retrieve the amulet.
Oh, yeah. Good thinking.
Yeah, you know.
I go and grab the amulet. I was like,
gonna
oh,
say,
I'm totally.
If you didn't say that, I was going to be like, don't.
Oh, you did a good job. Yeah. Oh, that's a good call, goat.
Obviously, I am a millennia-old goat. My knowledge far exceeds yours.
Right.
You got this down.
Yeah, you should have played this character from the beginning.
Right now, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'm taking the amulet.
Okay. You go grab the medallions.
Can I have my wolf just like go and like to, like start biting on the guy
yeah,
and
totally.
Like stop him from continuing to move?
Oh, foul canine!
I'm just gonna be like, I got questions for you, buddy. You're not going nowhere.
He is dragging himself into this chamber. All of the glass tanks have been destroyed. All of the experiments are like torn apart.
Yes.
And he pulls himself to the center of the room. And lays his hand on small handle set into the floor and turns it.
I like to think he wouldn't have made it, but okay.
He made it. Oh, the wolf can't kill him on its own. He's
I know, but I'm like trying to...
He's hobbled, but you had to run back and get the amulets and everything.
All right.
Oh, no.
Things have to happen.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
He twists the handle and says, my greatest work for Lord Darkathion. It must be completed. He turns the handle and the floor sections apart. All of the tiles, kind of like steam shoots out around them and the floor begins collapsing. He falls in. My life's work is done. None of you know what happened yet because none of you are in that room.
No. Cool.
Oh, God.
Yeah, that's like the only way out, huh?
Yeah.
Crap.
You're in his office, though. Would you like to search it at all?
Yeah.
Would you like to do anything in the broom closet?
I'm going to come out of the broom closet.
Coming out of the closet?
Yeah.
All right. You're in the hallway.
Would I know where the amulet is? Because I can sense
You can it. Sense that it is in the direction of his office.
All right. I'll walk in there and be like, the amulet exists.
I am searching his office.
Okay.
That's Bleats loudly.
Yeah.
6.
6? No. Yeah, it's not great.
You fool!
Roll to assist him.
The amulet is obviously here.
A +3 bonus because the goat is wise.
Do you want me to roll like something because EP was like trying to stop that dude?
I mean, sure, if you want.
I mean, just.
I just kind of assumed like he was going to be dealing kind of constant damage because that's what he does.
Well, I mean, like as far as like trying to get out of that room before the floor collapsed.
Oh, yeah, that's yeah, yeah, yeah. Fair. I kind of just figured he'd run out.
Yeah.
Like, cause
good
I,
then.
He doesn't really have his own health bar
yeah,
or anything.
That's
or
good
like
then.
Health hit points or anything, so I'm not going to. Yeah. No, he's fine.
Good.
You got an 11.
He catches up. You got an 11?
Right. Yeah.
Right, with his assistance, you locate the Moa Bird medallion.
Yes.
And a larger metallic disc, which you believe may open
be
another door you have seen.
Maybe a key.
Yes. Nice. It's in his desk.
Right. I'm just going to look at Goat also and be like, where's Bettania? Did she die also? Am I on my own here?
No, I'm right
That's
here.
That's cool.
Oh, there you are.
Watch your mouth, David.
Oh, hey.
I'm a goat now. You don't know what I'm saying.
Yeah. It's true.
Yeah, you see her bleeding.
Sko got sassier and meaner since the last time I saw him. Where's Dula?
Oh, he, my point.
Point at the funnel.
Oh, God.
It's half bones, half lizard.
Yeah, it's a
all
shame.
Dead.
Did you get the medallion?
I got the medallion.
Fine. Sorry. Yeah.
I'm going to put the Moa bird. I'm just going to, because there's just one that's a necklace and I'm wearing it.
Wait, you got both medallions?
Yeah, I have the Moa bird one. I found it.
Because
I found this cool little disc.
Because Dula had them all before.
He took my shark medallion.
No, I gave her one.
Oh,
remember,
that's right.
I have a soft one.
One.
I took his. I put that around my neck because it's the only one.
The shark one?
Yeah.
Right.
And now we have the Moa bird one.
Perfect.
And I'm going to put that in my bag.
Cool.
Along with the key.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's get out of here.
All right.
Let's go back the way we came. Oh, wait. Whoops.
Oh, shoot.
So you enter the room.
Something's...
We try to enter the room.
Well, as
there's
you're
no
doing
floor.
All this stuff, you hear smashing noises, like metal being torn apart, and a deafening roar, as well as just swooshing, sweeping sounds of, like, wind.
That does not sound
and
good.
And by the time...
I'm just going to be like...
You get to the room and peek around the corner.
Oh, no.
The floor is almost entirely gone, and it's collapsed into a large open chamber that was beneath. The metal is all melted and twisted apart everywhere.
Oh, we're in a volcano.
And the roof has been torn completely open.
Oh, no.
It looks like it's still red hot from whatever flames, like, blasted it apart.
Oh, boy.
You can hear stomping and roaring in the
distance. Outside.
Is
there any floor in this room?
There's enough.
Enough to get by?
You can get by if you take your time with it.
Okay.
But something big just busted out of here.
All right.
You don't know what.
But if we combine
Goblin guy's dead at the bottom?
He's dead. He looks dead. He's all burned apart.
Oh, it's all...
He's like a charred
body. If we go down there, we're going to die.
Oh, no, you could
go
down there if you want. Yeah.
I want to steal from that guy's body.
I don't feel like that's a very good thing to do. We already accidentally killed him.
He looks pretty burned.
He killed
himself.
You
can pick up his laser sword.
I was
going to
ask him a bunch of questions. I was going to keep
him
alive.
His laser sword was in his office, if you want to take that with you.
Can I take a laser sword?
Yeah.
He's not using it.
I guess take the laser sword.
Now you have a weapon to use in your second hand.
Oh, true.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah.
A regular sword and a laser sword.
Do I still do D8 damage with it? Is it like class based?
Yeah, I'll give it some extra bonus effect though.
Fine.
So
cool.
Yeah. So are you all gonna?
Yeah, let's just get out of here.
Get out of the lab. All right.
Yeah.
You leave the laboratory, not knowing what awaits you now.
This
on
the
does
outside. Not look good.
No, it
and
doesn't.
We are unfortunately pretty much out of time.
Okay.
So the culmination of all this will have to happen next episode.
It's a very eventful episode.
When we get to it. Yeah, a lot of stuff's going down.
Yeah,
we're getting to it.
Yeah.
We're getting to it.
We got the key.
You got the key to the temple.
You died.
Dula died.
Of your own accord. It was your fault.
That was faster than I thought it was going to happen.
Kind of.
It was faster than I thought it was going to happen.
Yeah, I was.
don't drink strange liquids.
He didn't even drink it.
Pour stuff down your pants.
Don't pour strange liquids down your pants.
I pretended to drink it.
Yeah,
well,
I thought
I thought it was like, if I don't drink it, then he's going to think we're not goblins.
I kind of got it. I was like, oh, I see what you're doing.
With my mouth, he'd be like, you're a lizard. Or whatever.
Very tall goblin.
Like, oh, yes, a tall goblin.
Tall goblin.
Or something.
I totally get what your plan was.
It makes sense.
It was just a bad one.
It was just bad in the
because my pants are invisible and everything underneath.
So it would look like you drank it.
It would look like
but also I got
until
the impression that
out of the legs of your pants.
I also got the impression
by that point,
but his legs would have been underneath. He had a desk. You wouldn't have seen it.
By that,
we're out of time.
We're out of time.
But we digress.
We digress. Thank you all for watching episode 5 of Dank Dungeons. We will be back with a 6th episode on NCTV and YouTube, which you can check out. And check out our Facebook and Twitter as well. And until next episode, pour one out for Dula Wula Fula, I guess. Never forget R.I.P. and pepperonis, etc.
But not down your pants.
Good night, everybody.